Hi friends, in this video we are going to look how we can host a React app on Firebase. So let's get started. First go to console.firebase.google.com and create a new project. Give it a name and you can also edit the project ID if you want. The project ID will be the website URL of your React application. Click on continue. Then if you want Google Analytics, you can turn it on. In our case, we don't need it, so we turned it off and click create project. The project will be created within a few seconds. After the project is created, go to your React application folder and install the Firebase tools. You can install it using npm I or npm install dash g Firebase tools. Dash g is required because we need to install it globally. So npm install dash g Firebase tools. Wait for the installation to complete. After the installation is completed, go ahead and log in to the Firebase. Type Firebase login. Then log in with your Google account. Choose a Google account and click allow. Now go back to your React application and you can see we are successfully logged in. Next, run the Firebase init command. This command is to initialize this project as a Firebase project. So you need to do this only for the first time. Use your arrow key to highlight the hosting option and press space to select the hosting, then hit enter. Highlight use an existing project and hit enter. Then choose your project name and hit enter. Give public directory as build folder, then answer all other questions with no. Now our project is initialized as a Firebase project. Next, we can build the React application by running yarn build or npm run build. After the build process is completed, you can run the final step, Firebase deploy. Wait for a few seconds. Now we can see a hosted website URL. You can control click the URL to open it in a browser, or you can copy paste. So our URL is myawesomeapp12.web.app. So after control clicking, you can see your React application is live there. If you make any changes to your code, just run yarn build or npm run build, then Firebase deploy. That's the only step you need to do every time you change the code. That's it for this video. Thanks for watching. Please don't forget to like, share, and subscribe to our channel.